Walter Jones Show. Weekdays, 4 p.m. Central on UBM Faith.
The following show is paid programming and does not necessarily express the views and opinions of Urban Broadcast Media and its subsidiaries.
Thank you for listening to UBM Praise.
Let's go.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
What's his name?
Sir Walter Jones.
Whose show is this?
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
Say it again.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who are you with?
Sir Walter Jones.
One more game.
Sir Walter Jones.
The Sir Walter Jones Show. Co-host Alvin Carter. We are a Christian talk show in where we tackle all the hot topics in a believer's walk. Monday is Men's Night. The Men's Chronicles, a woman's guide to men.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
What's his name?
Sir Walter Jones.
Whose show is this?
Sir Walter Jones.
Who is it?
Sir Walter Jones.
Say it again.
Sir Walter Jones.
Who are you with?
Sir Walter Jones.
One more game.
Sir Walter Jones.
Today is Monday, and that means it's the Men Chronicles, a women's guide to men. No, we are not from Mars, but we are from homes that raise us correctly and, more importantly, godly. Get to know us a little better in the Men's Chronicles, right here on the Sir Walter Jones Show.
Everybody, Sir Walter Jones Show. I am he. It is Monday. Men's Chronicles. It is a woman's guide to men. And we're here again talking to you, the men, about the ladies, about men. Got the great T.C. Thomas back in town. Alvin Sicada, he was out of town. He's back. I was in Indianapolis, Indiana, with the great Pastor Eric Jewel Hayes and many of those, my Baptist brothers and sisters down there. Capital Campaign. Shout out to Nally Bullock and Eric and his wife and all his cheering and all them folk out there. Restoration Baptist Church.
He said cheering.
Cheering. Yeah, chillin'. All them folk down there. Yeah, man. We busy. We crazy busy. But, we doing kingdom work and, we just got to get it done. Even Alan Sicada went down there to get his daughter out of college. It's summertime. That's part of kingdom work. Because a man,
kingdom work.
If he can't take care of his babies,
it's a lighter pockets.
Right, he's worse than an infidel if he don't take care of that baby. Because he don't take care, I will. You know, I ain't got no problem taking care of
babies. I want nobody.
I ain't got no problem taking care of the babies. I love the babies.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't love having babies.
As long as there's somebody else.
I'm not going down that road.
Three and that's.
I'm done. That's it. I'm out the game.
I'm out.
I made the show. I was out.
Today's show is called How to Listen to Your Woman.
Oh, Lord.
How to Listen to Your Woman.
Depending
on how she talks, I guess, huh?
Depending on when it is.
Right. You see what I'm saying?
I say it out.
And trust me, ladies, it's not just an all-men show. It's not a woman-bashing show because the great Tina Steele will be here.
Oh, Lord.
Right after she gets off work. We're going to do a 1 hour today because, again, we're going out to work. No, we don't bash. Men don't bash.
Women.
We don't understand what bashing looks like.
Mm-mm. We might smash, but we don't bash.
No, we don't bash. No. Mm-mm.
Now you do realize Jocelyn is listening in.
Right. That's her name, Jocelyn.
That's her name. That's Jocelyn. It. That's Jocelyn. It. She just celebrated a birthday too, so I better act right.
Happy birthday, Jocelyn.
I mean.
Okay, so if you're gonna talk about stuff, you better talk quiet.
Right.
Because she not only she's listening, she's watching this thing. You probably. Okay, and then Harris says, "Hey, TC, my bag." Okay, you see that right there. See, that's you're going to be on that.
Oh, all right. Hey, yeah, I'm
all
here.
Right. All right. Yeah. Okay. All right.
I'm glad to be back. She's man, I miss being around.
Man, we miss you too, man. We got to stop you running around America doing all this kingdom stuff.
I mean.
You're getting on my last nerve. Okay.
You and this kingdom stuff. What you talking about?
I'm getting that from y'all.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Because
I don't know what you're talking about, Willis.
Yeah, the solution to the age-old problem of understanding women may be as simple as taking the time to improve your own listening skills. Think about it. How many times have you said to yourself, my wife or girlfriend doesn't understand me? Mm. But it happens quite often. But don't worry. With a little practice, these moments of misunderstanding and miscommunication will come to an end. Okay? Identify the problem. And the problem might be you, the man. She is not the problem. I am. The sooner you learn to say these words, the sooner you'll be on the road to flawless communication.
She'll tell you you're lying. Yeah.
She will tell exactly. You you're lying. Yes.
Oh, no. Don't try to get out of it now. You're the problem. Mm-hmm. What's wrong?
Mm-hmm. I have repeatedly listened.
You don't hear me. You don't hear me talking.
I have repeatedly listened to couples talking or arguing, and it's clear that neither partner understands what the other is saying. She says ABC while you hear XYZ. So you respond to XYZ by saying QRS. Mm. That makes any sense?
I see why.
You see why?
Yeah. Yep. Especially if the game is on.
And after that, I want some PYT. Uh-huh. At this point, the significant other is confused because your response has little or nothing to do with what she just said. And she becomes upset because she's not getting her point across. So she'll try again, but with more anger in her voice, in time or in turn, you'll start getting angry. And with vicious cycle of miscommunication, it begins again. Okay? Help us out here, Dr. T.C. Thomas. Yeah, do you agree with this finding here?
I somewhat.
Somewhat.
Agree. Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you why.
Tell us
usually why. When... Our ladies, bless you, ladies. We love you. Usually, when our ladies, I want to get the Holy Ghost in real quick. Usually, when they start talking, it is the majority for men always at the wrong time. Mm-hmm. No matter whether the game is on, whether you just walked in the house, whether you have been doing something, you had your honey to do list. Mm-hmm. Don't care what's going on. Usually, it's always at the wrong time for the man. Now, what is the right time?
Right.
You usually have to have a 602 article discussion with him to find out when the right time is. And then at that point, you're able to ascertain when it is. But usually it's always the wrong time for the man. Why? Because men, let's be honest, we really don't want to talk about usually the things that you want to talk about.
True. You're right. That's true, right, Alvin? We really don't
want to
talk about
it. Well, timing is of utmost importance.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times... they wait until they're ready. That women are strategic.
Yep.
So a lot of times they know when the wrong time for you and the right time for them because they want to catch you when you're your most honest because they have strategized a plan to get the response they want.
Exactly.
Sure.
However, in moments of catastrophe or distress, I don't care what time is good, that's when you need to know to turn the ears on to hear true distress. And then you got a whole nother level of communication. But then right, that's when you also have to flip another switch and say, I hear what you're saying, but you're going to have to do what I say do so I can rescue you.
Yes, now. Ooh. Today's woman's really upset with that, just that last part.
I know.
They peed off at that last part.
Okay.
They don't feel they need to be rescued.
They don't feel no need.
You just listen to me and do what I say.
You see what I'm saying?
But yeah. If you had, half the time, if I had done that, we would be in worse positions.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Sure. Yeah.
There's a time when you listen to your woman.
Yes.
And God has given them certain tones to use. Mm-hmm. When they used an innate tones, like distress and danger is a scream. A man can't scream like a woman.
No.
Right.
That's something that gets attention.
Unless he's Prince.
And even still.
God rest
his soul. That still ain't a woman scream. That's just royal falsetto. That's
royal falsetto.
Yeah, that's royal falsetto. But then there's that soft and tender tone that she could use that will break down any wall of honor.
Sure will. Absolutely. That
but,
voice.
But here's a question. Why then does the woman not utilize that tone which can break down that man so that they can get them inextricably intertwined into where you want them to be? You're playing the wrong side of the fence.
But because in their mind they're thinking they have to be equal to
us. That's so true.
So they do what we do innately, they do mechanically.
Right.
So they figure the force that we have to use, they figure the strength that we have to use. I mean, that we use naturally.
Right,
they figure
right.
They got to use that with us to match up to us.
Okay.
When that is not what is necessary all the time. Yeah. You know, I don't know if a woman said it or not, but they say you can get more flies with something else.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Than you can with honey.
With honey than you can with other stuff.
Yeah,
that's
or vinegar.
Yeah,
or,
I just use vinegar.
Or use chocolate. Let's say that. Yeah. Reprocessed chocolate.
Exactly. Butterscotch, strawberry, you know all of those.
Yes. Because a soft answer turns away wrath.
Yeah.
And a soft voice will get your arms wrapped around you.
We'll get you to
so you want
to
wrath or you want to
wrath? Suddenly on
suddenly.
You.
Suddenly. That's so true. I think the situation of not using that calming voice that you mentioned, TC, is it makes her feel like she is submitting.
Right.
And many women don't want to submit.
No.
She want to be right.
Exactly.
And to do that puts her in a place of submission, which makes her feel like it's empowering
like
him.
Like you less than, and he's greater than. And when that's not the case, you just want him to hear you.
Yes.
So you have to, you know, sometimes you have to go and say, listen, I need a time where I can really talk to you when you can hear me.
Right.
So that I can get some things out that need, you know, because we listen with a response.
We do.
More than we do with understanding.
True.
Because as soon as you start, we've already got the answer. We've already given you the plan. Mm-hmm. And we've already told you, all right, I'll see you next week. Everything ought to be done. That's all in about 30 seconds.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I don't know all the time about that. I agree that a lot of times we do listen with a response. But I think we listen with a lie first. Let me stop. No, let me stop. Depending upon who's talking to you. Now, if it's your woman and what she's saying to you. If it comes down to issues of finances, issues of health care, or things like that, you're hearing what she says. You listen to that. And you do immediately start thinking of a solution.
Right.
You may not have it then. Of course, they want it then. So you're quiet. You're trying to process it. Or you're waiting to see the bridge so that you can cross it then. Because they want plan. They want A to Z plan at that moment. And that's not how we think.
Right.
So then they say, you're not hearing me. You don't listen to me. No, I'm thinking about what you just said.
Exactly. I'm processing.
I'm a processor. I'm planning it.
Exactly.
I'm looking at, okay, you said X, Y, Z. Let me deal with X first.
Right.
Y will come later. And I'll see you later.
I'll see you later. Okay. That's interesting. How can you ensure that this problem doesn't become habitual? The fact is that it's up to you to be a better listener. Being a good listener won't just make a huge difference in your relationship and sex life, but in every single aspect of your life that involves social interaction. In order to become a better listener, especially with women, we need to relearn some of our old beliefs. And here's one. It says, not realizing that listening is important. No one ever told us men that listening to women is an important part of being a man. So we tend to discount it. What do you think?
Read that one more time.
Sure. the not realizing that listening is an important part. No one ever told us men that listening to women is an important part of being a man. So we tend to discount it.
I don't know if I agree with that.
Okay.
Every player and pimp in the world will tell you that is wrong.
Yeah.
Because that's exactly what they do.
That's true.
They listen attentively. They listen. Exactly. So they can say, okay, that's what she said. Okay, I'm going to give her what she wants.
Right.
And I'm
because again, if you really are that pimp or player, you got a plan behind what she said.
Exactly.
So you're strategizing. So I don't agree with that because you are listening. Now, it determines what you say, determines which side I listen and how I listen. If you're saying something that tickles my ear, then I may perk up and listen a little more than if you're saying something that's dogmatic that I'm really not interested in, then I'm gonna shift back from it.
Sure. That makes sense. Okay. I agree with that. Well, here's another one. Understanding is not the same as agreeing. You don't have to agree with your partner. Just listen and try to understand. People are usually more receptive to working things out and compromising when they feel understood. So understanding is not the same as agreeing.
I agree with that.
I agree with that too.
I agree with that because we can.
I understand that.
Yeah. I understand what was just said. Uh-huh. I can understand what you say. I don't necessarily have to agree with. And I would tell you, you know, honey, I understand what you're saying. Now, I don't agree with it. You know, we're not going to climb the mountain on it, but at least I understand where you come from. So that old saying, we can agree to disagree. I can understand what you're saying and still not agree, and we not fall out behind it.
Sure. Okay. For those of you who just tuned in, Facebook Live Part 2, because we've been talking and I've been trying to get the app back up. The first part is we disagreed with the statement that they said not realizing that listening is important. It says no one ever told us men that listening to women is an important part of being a man, so we tend to discount it. And you disagree with it, TC.
Disagree with that.
And I was called to disagree with it. This next step is understanding is not the same as agreeing. You don't have to agree with your partner. Just listen and try to understand. People are usually more receptive to working things out and compromising when they feel understood.
Isn't that what women, what they say? Mm-hmm. I just want to be understood.
I want to be understood.
I want to be understood.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I agree with that. The next one here is not understanding the emotions expressed. Okay, we can be a week on this emotion thing.
Oh, man, I'm not going to know emotions no more.
Right.
Lord, today.
We can come past that.
Okay. Women are emotional creatures in general. Therefore, it's extremely important for men to recognize the different sets of emotion that women speak with. Mm-hmm. For women, the feeling is usually more important than the content of a conversation, but they would never admit to that.
Mm-hmm.
So for women, the feeling is usually more important than the content of the conversation.
Yeah.
You agree with that?
We know that. Well, I agree with that.
Yep, I agree.
I totally agree with that.
Circle gets the square.
Or many of them won't use the emotion. Okay, some have this innate emotion that just happens no matter what they do.
Right.
You know, they going in buying hair and they get emotional.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly, yeah.
You know, they just out of control.
Or if they ain't got the hair, they won't. They got emotion.
Yeah, it's emotional.
Mm-hmm. They finna fight. They get upset.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then you got to bring them off the ledge.
Right, exactly.
Come off the ledge.
Come off the ledge. And then there are those who use that emotion. She knows that crying, which really is my biggest pet peeve, is when a woman uses her tears.
Yeah,
my mother was a master of that.
Yeah, thinking it's going to get through.
She hit a switch and started crying. Mm-hmm. And just all kind of confusion would break out.
No, it don't get to me. I walk out.
Me too.
Now, the only time that I will stay and console a woman with tears is when I know it's genuine tears.
Exactly.
And she's really hurting.
There's something that has triggered that hurt.
You absolutely.
Know, that happened. I coach basketball, which you know. Mm-hmm. And last week at practice, there were two of my players who I got on. They were busted out crying. Mm-hmm. And the first thing I said was, cut the crying. I don't understand what the tears are. Just do what's been asked. Mm-hmm. And let's move forward. Now, if you're crying because you're upset at you, then that's fine. I've got no problem with that.
Right.
But if you just crying just arbitrarily to be crying because I hollered and screamed, that's where, and I'm with you, Doc, that's where my issues come. If it's genuine and I'm consoling you because you truly are, you know, hurt, great. But if you crying just to get a reaction out of me, you're going to get the wrong reaction.
Yeah, just let me cry. Yeah. Let me cry. I'm in touch with my feminine side.
Right, no tears.
Baby, don't you cry. Nothing wrong with a man crying.
Come on, Renee and Angela. Help us.
Come on, Renee and Angela. Yeah. Okay. So cut with the tears.
Yeah, cut the tears.
They call crocodile tears.
Exactly. Right? Don't you love when they, and they nothing falling?
Nothing, you know, just as fake as, I don't know what. Exactly. As fake as the eyelashes, okay?
23 long.
Yeah, they, all that work they do, yeah. They finna mess up their makeup.
No. Especially if they made all the way up. No. Notice how they dab up top for something happen.
Yeah.
When they cry for real.
Right. You dabbing in the
coat. Catch them tears before they hit the face.
Exactly.
They mess up.
I done put all this makeup on, and it ain't finna streak.
Okay, so ladies, what we're trying to say is we feel your pain.
Like, and we do feel it.
Cleansing.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's the worst thing that it is, when we feel your pain and you say, what's wrong? Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing. Right.
Don't that just tick you off?
And they want us to be honest.
Yeah, but they lie.
But right.
They
lie. But then they turn around and lie. Sure. Nothing. Mm-hmm. Then you want to come back an hour later when I'm in my space.
Absolutely.
I just want to talk about what was wrong. No, I asked you, baby, wrong. What was wrong? Ain't nothing wrong. So let's move on.
Let's move on.
See?
Don't worry, y'all. A woman is coming in the room, and she's going
to
set us straight.
Too bad it's going to be in
you hear you
5 minutes said, before we're done.
Brittany talking about thank the Lord.
Thank the Lord. She done got all religious on us. Brittany done got all holy on us.
She's coming in, but we've locked the doors. Yeah, but that's not important
right now. That's not important right now.
That woman will break her door down.
Yeah, she sure will.
Tear that door down, brother. Don't fool with her. Oh man, I keep getting knocked out. I'm gonna have to reboot something. I don't know what's going on. The next one is criticism. Hey, Brittany, I'm gonna do the news at 4:30. Okay.
Okay.
Criticism. If you need to be judgmental, be diplomatic about it. Just be diplomatic about it. Okay, I messed that up.
If you're gonna offer criticism, be diplomatic.
There is such a thing as positive constructive criticism.
Isn't that almost an oxymoron?
Yeah. I hate it when they do it, though.
Right.
Because they're masters of it.
Yeah.
It's so nice, but.
But. And the long but.
Yeah, but. Oh, that's so beautiful, but. You know, whatever. Either you like it or you don't.
Yeah, exactly. Just give it to me quick, fast, and in a hurry.
You like it or you don't. Okay. All right. I see that.
Babe, thanks for cooking dinner.
Uh-huh.
But.
It was a little,
We know next time you cook.
No. I'm not saying I want to cook, but then eat what's on the plate.
Now, here it is, though. That's what they'll do to us most times.
Right.
But if we...
We ain't got dinner. We
ain't going to eat no more.
We ain't going to eat no more. There's a McDonald's down the street.
They got a special.
They got two for...
I mean, now I'm going to my mama's house.
Right. I'm going to get a home-cooked meal.
Oh, my goodness. Don't try to fix things all the time. Okay, now you were kind of alluding to this.
I almost fell out on that one.
Yeah, men are under the misconception that they need to provide all the answers in a relationship. Not so. Make sure your partner is involved in many decision-making opportunities, as she will feel more needed, involved, and special.
I agree with that.
You know, and here's something. Dang, the door was unlocked. Ah. Here's something. Now, I really believe that there are moments and times that you have to ask the question, what do you want to see happen in my response? Do you want a response? Do you want me just to listen? Do you want me to provide direction? Because you can listen and get ready to give a response, and then you end up being wrong all the way around. So I think some of that you have to ask the question, okay, what do you want? How will our time best be spent? Because what I don't want to do is to go left like tweet, and next thing you realize, you didn't want me to go left. So, you know, that's the question that needs to be asked.
Someone asked the question.
Right? Why did I give an opinion?
Okay, that makes sense. I'm feeling that. All right. That was, let's see. What was that, by the way? We were talking about don't fix. Right. Don't fix things.
Don't fix
things. Don't fix it. Because of women, I have experienced many women who just, they told me or they wanted me to see the issue.
Mm-hmm.
But not for me to start acting like I'm a brain surgeon and fixing the problem. It just needed me in the room or present.
Then they may shift back to feeling like, well, what do you think? I'm not able to solve the problem. Yeah, I'm not able to. And so you're really, you know, in a catch-22.
It's called making it count, bro. What it is making it count. You take the assessment. Do I really need to answer this question? Mm-hmm. Does it really need to be fixed? Is it really a problem? Mm-hmm. How big of a problem is it? Is it one of those problems that will solve itself? Or is it a problem that she's creating and making it bigger than what it is? Or do I not fix it? Or do I fix it and don't care what the outcome is because it needs to be fixed?
Right.
So the question is, do you do that analysis based on how big you think the problem is, or from her perspective? Because being a man, some things that you may find to be very small or like minutia, it may be like this heavy duty.
What country is that?
Thing, a very minute problem. So part of you shut up. So it depends. Like, so what perspective are you coming from, Alvin? When you say, is it a big problem or is it not?
Alvin Sicardo.
What do you mean? It depends on the problem. So I have to listen. And it says, don't solve it, but you have to be processing it based upon what it is.
But,
Okay, case in point. Here's one, a good one. The oil light came on. Okay.
Okay, yeah.
That means oil needs to go in the
engine. That means oil change.
So oil change.
Yeah.
So was that the only light that came on, though?
That's all I was told.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And depending upon the woman, does that mean I get up and go put oil in the car? Or does that mean, okay, thanks for letting me know.
Right.
Do I get up right then and do it?
Or do I wait a while?
But then me, I go, how long has it been on?
Mm-hmm. Did it just come on?
Did it just
come on? Is that the only light?
But then you can ascertain, you know.
Did it just come on?
Yep,
how long has it been on?
Yep.
It's been on a while. Or better yet, the car stopped.
Yeah. Okay.
How did it stop?
What was going on?
Is it because you put the brakes on it?
Right.
Or
did you have a stick shift and you didn't do
it? Right. Were you clutching it?
So there's questions.
Yeah. So you have to.
Questions.
I was just going to say.
You asked how.
No, how do we process? I get it. Like, okay. I totally understand. Like, I get that. But I just wanted to bring up the point that sometimes when we're trying to decide whether or not a problem is actually a problem or a big problem, we have to take the other person's perspective and not just go on our own experience and the way that we interpret it. So what you did was great. You asked follow-up questions and then you ascertained what you should do from there. Yes. But a lot of people don't do that.
Yeah, well, you know, you have to know your woman.
Amen.
Exactly.
You
exactly.
Have to know your woman.
Know your woman.
Or know which woman you're dealing with at that time.
Exactly.
Oh, my.
You're getting confused.
Hi, Walter.
My name is Baby, ain't it?
I'm sorry. I thought I was dealing with Sally. My fault.
Wow. That's another show, like philandering men.
I know a guy named Philander. He's a good preacher.
We've got about 3,000 members.
Oh,
3,000 members.
Great musician, too.
Yeah, he's.
You know Philander Lewis, don't you, Bob?
Yeah, I know Philander. Yeah. Raise him, man. Raise him up myself. Tina, how you doing? Doing good?
I'm doing well, still a little jet lagged, but
yeah.
You got that African.
You come a long way, girl.
I know. I got a tan. You see got, that?
Yeah, you are tan.
You got about 10 tans.
Yeah. Oh, whatever.
The elbow is darker than the forearm and
long braid earrings.
Really?
I mean, everybody ain't able.
Really?
Everybody ain't able. And she actually wear the same color. She matches.
Right. I wish y'all could see her.
Oh my gosh.
She look across. She looked like the ocean she crossed. Am I blue?
Am I blue?
Wow.
I don't know what to do with y'all. Hey, we're talking about, what are we talking about? Oh, yeah, how to listen to your woman. And trust me, ladies, we're going to get to the part that you like the most.
What's that?
For men to be quiet, all right? Mm. We'll get to that part. I know y'all like, okay, you didn't ask the question. A bunch of y'all doing women
everything
bashing and everything. Yeah, don't worry. Bashing. We are definitely going to get to the place where we solve this problem for men. Because the question is asked so that we know how to listen to the woman. Sometimes, unfortunately, and this is your doctor tell you the same thing. When you go say, this hurts, he says, what did you do to make it hurt? Okay? Because you probably did something. And you brought it here for me to fix it. You're going to go back out there and do the same thing. So my job is to help you stop doing that thing that makes you hurt.
So you just did a segue to the age-old response that most men make.
What's that?
What you telling me for?
Yeah.
Right.
Exactly.
And I'm supposed to do what?
I'm supposed to do what with this?
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. So when we come back, we're going to try to figure out, because this first half, we try to figure out what was her problem, why we can't listen to her. When we come back, we'll figure out what's our problem, why we can't listen to her. Okay?
Okay.
How fair is that?
That's fair.
All right.
That's fair.
Sounds good to me. I'll do some news early tonight, and we'll come right back. So, Walter Jones Show.
Oh no! Did you miss part of today's show? Well, just head to Spreaker.com. That is Spreaker, Spreaker.com, and type in the Sir Walter Jones Show to get today's episode and past ones. So do it now.
Coming down from the weekend, April 29th through May 1st, y'all. Illinois, man crushed by garbage. The Rockford landfill is under investigation by the U.S. Occupational Safety and Health Administration after Gonzalo Trevino, age 54, was buried under the weight of a tripped over garbage truck and its contents. Authorities say the garbage truck contained 80,000 pounds of concrete, steel, wool, wood, and other building debris. Trevino was unloading a garbage truck when the load from a second truck shifted. The Winnebago County coroner says Trevino was killed by the blunt force to the abdomen and the chest. Goodbye, Dumbo. Sadly, we have to say goodbye to Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus, performing Elephants as the show closes own chapter on a practice that has entertained audiences in America for two centuries. The keeping of the elephants has come under fire by animal rights activists. The six Asian elephants have more than 100 years of service. St. Jude Parade. Thousands of uninformed Chicago police officers will honor their fellow officers who were killed in the line of duty through the years. And this probably means I don't know, uniform. She got uninformed here. But it's uniform. As this month is dedicated to officers, the memorial will continue in Washington later this month. She's going to get me because my eyes are not that great, too. Here are the five top things women want most in a man. Number five, kind gestures of love. Number four, they want fun. Number three, understanding. Number two, they want time. And number one, they want to be appreciated. That's your five things from Marilyn Keita for the Sir Walter Jones Show. Facebook. Welcome back to Facebook. That's what you get for multitasking. Welcome back to the So About the Jones Show. We're talking about how to listen to women. Women's. Okay? And it is so important. We got a woman in the room here to see what we could do about making sense of this subject here, madam. Let's see. Well, let's see. I'm sorry, guys, because, you know, part three is up on Facebook Live, and it keeps going out on me, and I know what it is, and I'm going to fix it tonight, so this won't happen tomorrow. But J-Mo Pro's on there. He said this should be good. Unfortunately, you won't be able to hear it or see it till tonight. Lady Rochelle said the app sucks.
Oh, wow.
But you didn't hear it from me, though.
Tell us how you feel, Rick.
Tell us how you really feel.
Which app?
Oh, yeah. The UBM app. ain't no good. Okay, let me continue with this list here. Let's see if we can make sense of this. What kind of fade was that, Brittany? Okay. I mean, you tired of them?
I'm just done. I quit.
Just,
I'm
done. Right.
Burn.
What she said? Well, she said, worry about Facebook Live.
And with the point, too. Wow.
How is my subordinate going to tell me to be
fine?
I mean, I ain't instigating nothing. I'm just saying.
Can you believe she's blowing off of me like that on the air?
Yeah.
Man,
so fashionable.
I can't wait. I cannot wait to dock some pay in here. Let's see. Criticism is the next one. If you need to be judgmental, be diplomatic about it. There is such a thing as positive constructive criticism. That was the next one. Don't try to fix everything. We said that one. Now, here are the rules of effective listening. Okay, let's see if we can make sense of this in the next 20 minutes. Remember that your one and only job while listening is to understand her experience, feelings, attitude, or point of view.
And that's a whole lot.
Yes, that's your whole job.
It didn't say anything in there about responding.
No.
Okay.
I didn't say that. Not yet.
Well, effective listening, a lot of people listen to respond and not to understand. And so in that, you diminish the other person's story. Like, you diminish their narrative. And you also miss key points or key pointers that will tell you whether or not they want you or she wants you to do follow up and, like, fix something. Or she just needs to get it out. A lot of times people need to talk things out loud, and they don't talk to themselves. So you're just a sounding board.
I disagree with that. I've had some of my best conversations.
Well, I know some people don't talk to themselves.
Don't nobody understand me like me.
I mean, no, I agree. But, you know, but some people don't feel comfortable doing that because
of
the stigma.
A lot of things by myself of myself.
Oh, Jesus.
Nope.
Okay, I will agree with you. I'll give you the possession arrow. But I'll give you the possession arrow.
That boy good.
Is this like basketball talk? Okay.
But I have a slight proclivity with what you stated, because now, after you have stated the problem and I've listened intently and I don't respond, if I did not ask the question early to say, how do you want our time best spent? Then if I don't respond and I get up and go in the kitchen, well, what do you think about what I said?
Well, what if...
I mean, why you just walk off?
But what if they don't know?
Like a true
what if they don't know exactly like how, what is time well spent, right? What if I honestly say, you know what? I don't know, but can I just get it out? And then we can determine that after, you know, I get it all out. So leaving space for someone to say that, I think that's also important. So a lot of times people think when something happens or somebody tells you a story or shares a problem, that immediately you have to get some kind of response and be like all scientific or theological or psychological. And I think we need to realize is that I don't necessarily have to respond in the moment, because sometimes responding in the moment is not the most appropriate thing.
I will agree with you again. With mm-hmm. the
you said that,
arrow.
But women want you to respond
exactly.
Right there.
Exactly.
Some women, I mean, well, at least acknowledge the fact that you heard me. You don't have to figure things out. You know, say, you know what? I understand that. Or you can, like, paraphrase. There are things that you can do. Another part of listening and communicating is paraphrasing, kind of summarizing what you heard the other person say and get clarity to make sure that's exactly what they said. Now, if a person is defensive, and, you know, y'all already got some stuff going on, mm-hmm. that may not work well for you.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, just getting clarity at that point, I think, is important for me.
Okay, clarity. Mm-hmm. All right. That's clarity. That's
that's clear.
The kids and the cousin of
clarity and Clairol.
Yeah, Clairol.
And Clairol.
Clorox.
Wow, mm-hmm. Really, Clorox?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah.
Bleach
is clear. Yeah. And Chanel, number 5 and 6. Always give her your undivided attention. Make sure that you're not watching the football game while she's trying
to
discuss.
Don't come in the room asking questions. Now,
I agree with that. You know, I totally agree. I'm a football person myself, but if a person is occupied, I think it's disrespectful to just go in and automatically just kind of bully your way into their space and expect to get them to give you undivided attention. The best thing to do is say, do you have 5 or 10 minutes to talk to me right now, or would later be better?
Later.
I mean, what I'm saying, I'll be pissed off at you. Let me finish getting it out. You know,
we just let you know, don't give us that option. Later's going to always be the response.
I mean, but don't if I can't, that we if are the I procrastination, can't get your, but if I can't get your undivided attention, I'm fine with later, because that's disrespectful.
So let me ask this question then. So you're saying if I'm in the middle watching the game, so you walk in the middle of the game and ask me, can I talk to you, or is later a better time?
You better talk to me later. I know that.
Yeah, you know, and I think women self-inflict themselves when they come into a room with a man. She knows what that is the important thing in that man's mind, and then she bring on something important to her that can wait. Something right. that can wait. I'm talking about the kid is sick.
She uses her device.
What device is that?
Baby.
Yeah.
Can I talk to you now, or do you prefer me to wait later?
Yeah. Soft answer.
You know, or, you know, the thing is, some women are immature. And they want to see, they'll take that as, oh, you choose football over me. Like, that is so immature and so, like, and that's grow
where you, up. That's where you tell them, I'm sorry, I have a lot of letters behind my name. So we don't want to use that psychology.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Yeah, that's so true. Okay? So don't inflict yourself, ladies, okay, when you're going
to
the room.
That means don't set yourself up for failure.
Don't do it. Exactly. Yeah.
Exactly.
If it's something important, really, a woman knows, if she's been with a man long enough, she knows how to get through to him.
Unless she has a relational LD deficiency.
Yeah, there's a deficiency. I guarantee that. The next one is help her along by asking questions to encourage her to open up and to clarify things for you. Okay, my post yesterday was about asking her some questions. And, you know, women are more honest than men. Usually, they are more honest than we are. They'll tell you some stuff. Now, they still will withhold some stuff.
Yeah.
They will. Because they're not going to tell you everything.
That ain't honest then.
Yeah.
That's a distorted but honest
But they're more
view.
Honest than we are.
I don't know about that either.
They are more honest than we are. Because we just lie through our teeth.
They slick as goose grease. They laugh for different
goose
reasons.
And honey.
They laugh at
different I wouldn't know because I don't have. Nope, I don't
yeah.
lie.
Mm-hmm. We'll tell it over a period of time, a long period of time. And usually after we just ain't got nothing else that we can actually come up with. Then we'll say, okay, baby, dang. It's gonna hurt me.
I've lost interest after that.
But that's why we lie. We lie to protect. They lie to hide.
Yeah.
Right.
You lie that's to true. Do what?
We to do protect. Lie to protect. We do. Mm-hmm. We really do.
Oh, you're protecting yourself?
As no, crazy as that seems. Yeah. As crazy as that seems, we do lie to protect.
Because if we tell the truth,
yes.
then you're going to walk away and be hurt. Absolutely. And then we're going to have to deal with the tears that we were talking about before.
Nope.
Yep.
You just lying.
That's the other reason why we lie. We lie to protect the fight for you saying you just lying when we tell the truth.
Exactly.
You
see what I'm saying? So then I tell the truth. Then you say, you just lying. So I can't win.
I will do good. You think I'm like,
but evil. Evil is just always present.
Whatever. See, and that is such... Really? See? I lied to you to protect you, okay?
You see what I'm saying?
Would I lie to you?
Right.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Would I lie to you?
Come on, Andy Lennox, help us.
Yeah.
Would I say
we have the Victor Newman, Young and the Restless theology. I protect my family.
And you know, and even though it may seem ridiculous to the lady that it's just some excuse, it's still the answer. It's the real answer.
But then why do y'all act like the world just came to an end and there's an apocalypse when we lie to you? Lie? Yeah, right. Just like, you did the same thing.
The effort that it takes to catch a woman, it takes a serious skill set or a whole lot of luck to catch a woman in the locker. Yeah. Y'all smart.
Y'all
slick.
Yeah.
Y'all
cover the tracks.
Y'all cunning. Know how to do it right. Mm. Yes. So when we do catch you, all the work that it took to catch, and then all of the backdraft that come with it, because y'all lies have layers.
Yeah, it does.
Yes. I don't know what you're talking about, because I don't lie. I don't have to.
As you look away from us.
As you look away. Look away, into the left. Little girl.
Right, exactly. There's tweet again.
General Pro said, for the last time, this should be good. He keep getting cut off. Eve Cook, but we see
we need to have him on this show.
We got to have him on the show. But we see through the lie, even if we don't say anything. That's true.
A lot of times, because I think a lot of times, a beautiful lie, ugly truth, right? Mm-hmm. So it's like a lot of women would want to accept the beautiful lie as opposed to facing the ugly truth. Mm-hmm. Because the ugly truth can reveal things about both parties, right, and about the fidelity of the relationship,
that
right?
You don't want it, yeah.
And exactly, unpeeling the layers of a friendship that may be, it's not what you, what it cracked up to be.
Right.
And so, and then you have to look at, it reminds me of when we did that show on Bobby and Whitney, the Whitney Houston effect, and why she quote unquote mm-hmm. stayed with Bobby. And a lot of it was people already counted them out.
Right.
So she wanted to stay there to prove a point.
To prove a point.
And a lot of people, they accept these ugly, these beautiful lies because they don't want to prove the point of other people saying mm-hmm. that this was a farce. You know, this was this big fairy tale.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm sorry. I just don't. I mean, my whole thing is lies always hurt people in the end because it comes out.
Yeah.
Period. You can only lie for so long.
Yes, and that's so true. And if you keep lying, you're going to forget what lie you told.
Yes,
yeah, my mama said you got to tell the same one.
You got to keep telling the same one. And that takes a good actor.
And that takes a great actor.
Yeah, absolutely. Lady Rochelle Matheny is saying, tell me the truth now. And now, okay, I'll respond to that later. Tell me the truth now and give me a chance to process it and get over it so we can get back to loving each other.
Because you take now, away the other person's option.
That's true. Now, that's a sensible answer from a person who's more mature, mm-hmm. okay, who understands the importance of loving and restoration.
Mm-hmm.
Then there's the other one.
I was going to say, then there's the other side.
There's the other side of a woman who can't take the truth no matter.
You can't handle the truth.
But then why are you with a person like that?
How about maybe you didn't know that they really couldn't handle the truth because you haven't been faced with that situation of its magnitude yet.
Yeah.
So, like, as simple as, does this color bring out my complexion? No, it makes you look dead. Like,
you better tell the truth.
I mean, you know what I'm saying?
Because I'm going to walk around with a dead looking woman.
That's what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, like, it starts with little things. Mm-hmm. When you tell those quote unquote little white lies, it makes you comfortable and easily susceptible to building on that lie. And pretty soon, you're living a double life or a triple life.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. I stopped lying to a woman who asked me of an opinion because I don't want to hurt her. I tell her something else. Mm-hmm. I stopped doing that mess. When I got married, my wife at the time cooked a meal for me that she thought was going to be my favorite meal.
Yep.
And when I bit into it, my manly compassion, because I didn't like it.
Yeah.
My manly compassion says, okay, tell her
it tastes good.
Okay.
Yeah.
But then my long-term brain,
mm-hmm.
who's probably going to make her feel that this is my favorite meal and she's going to make it every Monday for the rest of my life.
Yep.
You better save yourself, Walter.
Yep.
Tell her. Tell her this
you
is.
You better tell her this
okay.
is.
Okay. But now how I tell her
right.
is what's going to either heal or hurt her.
Mm-hmm.
So I told her, I didn't tell her this is nasty. No, mm-hmm. I told her, you know what you should do? You should put some more salt in this and put it in the oven for another about 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I'm telling you, trust me on this one.
Yep.
It's going to make that meat fall off that bone.
But see, you were motivated by love and compassion mm-hmm, for her mm-hmm, mm-hmm. and not trying to, it wasn't a selfish motivation.
Right.
So it always, it comes to, what is your motivation? Is your motivation love? Yeah. Is your motivation towards the other person?
Mm-hmm.
Or are you just trying to be funny? You know what I'm saying? Because some people are immature. Some men are immature.
Yeah.
Where you just want shock value.
Yeah, you just
like, that stuff was horrible. Yeah. That tastes like flop or whatever.
That's horrible.
And you want the shock value, but you don't understand the power of your words and how you've injured the other person.
You've heard of.
So it's crazy. I wonder sometimes if we could actually see inside a person's heart
mm-hmm.
and inside their spirit and soul mm-hmm. and actually see what injury words can do to them. It's like a spear, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, and James talked about how the tongue is small, but it's set it can set ablaze and just and kill people.
Ship. It's an unruly evil.
So, you know, it's just like when we do things that are motivated by love and the best interest of the person.
Mm-hmm.
It may hurt,
but
that person will know that eventually, once they get out of their feelings, they will realize, okay, this person did this for my betterment. It was not for my detriment.
Well, and look at how he said it. He said it to the point where she could hear him
mm-hmm.
and she could understand what he's saying. Now, the hope in prayer is that she doesn't walk away defeated because
he didn't like it. Mm-hmm. Because what that also happens as well. Well, I'm just not going to cook anymore.
But he gave her options, he
did.
Right?
He did.
He gave her suggestions.
He did. Mm-hmm. He did. So yeah. So then, but, you know, like I do, there's some women who will walk away with, well, I'm just not going to cook anymore. Mm-hmm. When they're saying, hey, I didn't say don't cook anymore.
Yes.
You asked me, but then you beat me up. Because I gave you an honest,
but it wasn't just
coaching answer. That's not beating you up.
Coaching,
exactly.
Right?
It's coaching.
There's this. It's. I'm not just giving you a critique,
right?
But what I am, I'm offering.
Yeah, I'm not checking.
I'm offering some.
I'm not checking the sheet.
Exactly.
I'm saying, hey, you know what? This will help enhance it. So make that again, and let's come back to the table.
And so we use that a lot in the educational arena.
Yep,
we coach, it's collaborative coaching and actually allowing a person to kind of step back and do this self-assessment or this self-evaluation. And together we come up with actionable steps. And so the problem is that so many of us are so immature and we are so self-centered and so insecure that we can't take collaborative feedback. We can't take any kind of criticism, even if it's going to make you better.
Exactly.
So that's why a lot of us, when the Bible says that God chastens those he loves,
He loves.
So if you are a child of God, he's going to chasten you.
Exactly.
You should be, you know, that correction is important.
Right.
But we don't accept correction anymore.
No, we look at
correction as rejection.
Right.
But correction means that I accept you and I receive you and I want you to be better.
Exactly.
So how do we move from this? There's correction and there's constructive criticism to this is going to define me and name me. So it's a deeper problem.
Right.
It's a deeper issue when you can't accept somebody who loves you and they can't give you feedback.
Yeah, exactly. So then what does that mean for everybody else?
Exactly.
That you come in contact with.
But it's so superficial because somebody else can say the same thing and we won't quote unquote be hurt.
No.
We'll make the necessary changes.
Right.
But somebody who loves you, who you really should feel they have your best interest at heart.
Exactly.
They can't tell you nothing.
Exactly.
That's a problem.
Yeah, that's a real problem.
Kenyatta says, nope, be real because I am going to be. She means real, okay? You get to a point in life where even the most beautiful lie is beyond damaging. It's beyond damaging. Melissa Green is saying, again, be honest as I am honest with you. Okay, many of these women
says, sometimes y'all can't take honesty.
Sometimes women, you can't, but I mean, I'm trusting that they know themselves.
No, love works.
Yeah. Yeah, I hear what you're saying, Tina. Love works. No ill to his neighbor. Natalie says, you better speak on it. Let's see. And J-Mo said, you're talking good, Tina. Okay.
I'm talking good.
Furthering this notes here as I try to wrap this up, try not to be sarcastic.
Uh-oh. That's hard.
Yep. Yeah, when you do this, it insults the intelligence of your partner. Try to understand the feeling behind what she's saying as well as the content, okay? And the last one they say in here, show her that you truly understand her point of view and whether or not you agree with it, talk to her in a calm and composed manner. Remember, as soon as your tone of voice goes up, she will, so will hers, and vice versa. Mm-hmm. If she's yelling, then bring your voice down, and she will eventually do the same.
Because it's hard to yell at somebody who is not yelling.
Man, that's so true.
Yeah, I tell you.
I'm telling you, it works every time. You know, I
could have wrote that out.
I hear.
We said that before.
We said it before. Yeah, we did. We've done before, so many shows.
No, but we said it today. We didn't know that was on there.
Yeah, that is so true.
We said it earlier.
Yep, exactly.
It's all about how you approach
all
it.
All in how you approach it.
Baby, I need an eagle feather off the top of the mountain.
Yeah.
Can you? All right, as soon as the commercial come on.
Absolutely.
No, right.
Yeah,
I get it.
Communication.
Hey, sweetie, I'm sorry to bother you.
Sure.
I know that you're busy, but could you? And it's like, yes, whatever.
Well, they've done so much study and science.
I'll be right
back.
Right. Pause.
They said that the communication is not so much about the content; it's more about the expression or the tone of it.
Not which what you it, say, it's how you say it.
Yeah,
baby.
It's really how you say it, and public speakers know this. Those in politics, they really know this.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I look at some of the presidential debates. These people who are coaching them tell them all the time behind the closed doors, you know what? It really don't matter what you're saying.
Right.
It's how you say it. And I'll never forget.
Well, we know that as preachers.
Yeah, we do.
If you got a good hoop, you can say chills and finger toes.
I wouldn't know. Yep. They talk about them.
Oh, absolutely. I remember when Bill Clinton, and who was he running against at that? Was it George Bush?
It was, No.
Sorry.
I know what you're talking about. He was president of DNC at the time. He yelled, and they used his voice.
It was Bush Sr.
Oh, okay.
Bush Sr. was running, 93
yes,
or something like that.
He was going in for a second.
Second. He was second trying term. To get in. Yeah, second.
He was trying to get in, and he lost it.
Right. So somebody from the audience, a woman, asked a question to George Sr., and George Sr. kept looking at his watch.
Yep.
He's like, okay. And so she asked him a question. He was like, I don't know. He seems hesitant to answer the question, and he seems kind of like, okay, let's hear him get this over with. And then Clinton... Mm-hmm. Now, George Bush was sitting down in a chair, and all of them were. Clinton got up mm-hmm. and walked over to her. Mm-hmm. And it's almost like he held her hand.
Right.
Let me talk to you.
Exactly.
Well, you know, he's a brother.
He says, let me. Now, watch this. The pundit said that he never answered the question.
Right.
He never answered the question. But his tone was, I feel your pain.
Exactly. So exactly. He drew her in.
Yeah, he drew
right,
her.
Right, right.
I mean, but it's the same thing with, like,
you want to hit
kids. Oh, God. You know, in a classroom of students.
Yeah.
You know, like, sometimes kids are really, really irate, and I always do this. Okay, I need you to match my voice.
Sure.
I need you to match my voice. And they're like, she's not yelling at me. You know, so it's like, and you do that with people. Like, I need you, because you can't scream and be upset with somebody who's like speaking to you in a soft tone.
I do the same thing. I teach fifth grade. And first thing I tell them, if you can hear my voice, clap once. If you can see my face, clap twice. And then all of a sudden, everybody's like, and they know when all right, when Mr. Thomas walks in, we have to, you know, so they automatically come mm-hmm. down. And it's how you control the room. It's the same thing with women.
Yeah.
It's how you control the situation and not manipulate, but you control it so that they understand, you know what, I am interested in what you're saying. I may not be able to respond right now. I'll give you that, but let me, you know, I do you a disservice if I don't walk away the person that I am. And my wife tell you, he's a processor. I ask him something, it may be 2-3 days.
Because intel.
Yeah, because I've gotta go away and I've gotta think about it.
Sure.
Oh, you know. That's me.
But knowing you, right? But she knows you.
Exactly.
And so it's deeper than that. It's deeper than just asking questions. You have to know your partner or know the person that you're engaging with.
Yeah.
And you cannot be selfish when it comes to asking questions and getting information.
Yeah.
You have to consider the other person before yourself.
Right.
Not to your detriment, but for understanding's sake.
Exactly.
Consider yourself. Lest ye also be. Okay. I had to put that in there. Amen to that.
Hallelujah.
Tomorrow we're talking about how to listen to your man. How to listen to your man. We're going to do 2 hours with that one, y'all.
Yeah.
So
y'all
going
to be about 2 hours of how to listen to your man.
Give her a mic, man.
Okay.
Let me get back here tomorrow.
Y'all need to get back here tomorrow.
Y'all need to get back here tomorrow.
So we're going to pour out our hearts to tell y'all how to listen to us.
My gosh.
It really is easy if you really pay attention to it. Okay, don't
the
give
only
it
tap. Okay.
Give it tomorrow.
Don't give it away. One time.
Give it tomorrow. Yeah, give it tomorrow. Okay, I want to apologize to Barack Obama and Michelle. We didn't get a chance
Michelle
to interview you today. We're sorry about that.
Obama's out.
Obama, like, yeah.
Dude,
so we'll come tomorrow. Mike, we'll get you
off the mic.
We want to also congratulate, who was it? Malia? Who's not my name?
Malia.
I said Malia, which that's my goddaughter. But Malia, who is taking a gap. I think she's taking a gap, and then she's going to Harvard University. That's what your fathers and your parents, that's what you want.
Yep.
You want them to go to that alma mater.
Exactly.
Just a great thing.
I just want them to go.
Yeah.
Go.
I just want them to go, right.
Go.
Yeah.
Tell John the Baptist. There's a call at the courtesy phone.
Okay, man. So listen to your ladies. Just sit down. Matter of fact, go for a walk. I tell you all the time. Take your woman out for a walk and just let her vent. All right, and let her talk and hear her out, and don't just be listening with your ears, thinking that you know she know when you're fake when you're fake listening. Yeah, let her vent, and then respond in kind, but respond with wisdom if you can. Okay, all right, y'all, go to Spreaker.com. You can hear the whole show without all this cutting in and cutting out. These guys are having fun. I'm going to let them continue as we get out of here.
You know,
on our way to every single
no.
Welcome to Chicago, the Elders Convention.
Get all that in
of the Church of God in Christ. The men's conference is here. the International Church. So you are, y'all gonna see a whole bunch of Kojic folk in town.
Oh, that's all week long.
That's what all this traffic is from. Mm-hmm. All right. So bless the Kojic brothers and sisters.
Right, right, right. Yep. Okay, gotta go, y'all. Love you, Facebook. No after show. I'm sorry. I gotta get out of here. Thank you, Tina Steele.
No after party.
Thank you, TC.
Hey, you got it.
I'm telling Joshlin on you. I'm Sakata. Well, you're doing the best you can.
Help me, Lord Jesus.
So off the Jones Show.
Hey, ladies and gents, if you missed any of today's show, head to Spreaker.com and search the Sir Walter Jones Show and listen to this show and past shows. Now, remember, search for the Sir Walter Jones Show on Spreaker.com. That's Spreaker spelled Spreaker.com. And enjoy.
You have been listening to the Sir Walter Jones Show, where Sir Walter Jones provides you with a biblical perspective on everyday life. Stay connected to Sir Walter Jones at his website, www.sirwalterjones.com. Search the Sir Walter Jones Show on Facebook or follow on Twitter at Sir Walter's Music. Until next time, thank you for listening to the Sir Walter Jones Show with Sir Walter Jones.
Thank you, Mr. Walters.